and you can see by the axis of the hex key, the doctor in this case used all multi-unit level scan abutments, not implant level. This is the maximum angulation that you have. Hi everyone, welcome back to XGate Dental. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh, and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will provide interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases. Don't forget to subscribe and follow us to keep up to date. Let's get started. What we want to talk about is making an immediate restoration on immediate implantation cases when you have a lot of multi-units. In this process, we'll discuss when and how you choose between straight and angulated multi-units. We'll see how we know where the screw channels will go or where the future screw channels will be. So, in here, you can see the panoramic view at the end of the implantation and restoration. You can see that we have different types of multi-units. You'll be able to see the two that are angulated. You have some straight multi-units and some of the implants we prefer to put healing caps and don't restore them. So after we place the implants, we preferably would like to place an angulated or straight multi-unit. If you place in straight multi-units, you know right away where the screw channel will be because the screw channel will be in the same axis of the implant and right above the implant. When you place in an angulated multi-unit, in many cases, you can see right away where the screw channel will be. You can see here we have two straight multi-units, and you can see by the axis of the hex key of the multi-unit, the positioning and the axis of the future screw channel. When you're using an angulated multi-unit, for example, this one, it's hard to know exactly where the screw channel will be. So for angulated multi-units, we have a type of handle that, first of all, it helps us position the multi-unit on top of the implant. And with that handle, we can now see where the future access will be. The access of the implant goes right here, right of the access of the implant, but the access of the screw channel will be about 30 degrees palatally, which you can see by the handle of the multi-units. The next step is taking impressions. We place scan abutments on top of all the multi-units. We use different types of multi-units for the straight multi-units. We use multi-units of V-type. The angulated multi-units are on the D-type. So you have two different kinds of abutments here. You can see by the ring around the scan abutments that we took impressions on top of all the multi-units. And with this impression, we made a temporary restoration. The temporary restoration was made the next day and screwed to these multi-units. The doctor in this case used all multi-unit level scan abutments, not implant level. You have to use implant level scan abutments. We talked about it before in the CAD/CAM topic that you can use implant level scan abutments if you're not sure. But in cases where you're sure of what type of multi-unit you'll have, you can take a multi-unit level scan abutment, insert in the multi-unit, and take the impression straight on the multi-unit. If you take an impression on the multi-unit level, for example, for multi-unit 30 degrees, which is the multi-unit that we chose here, this is the maximum angulation that you have. For example, if the screw channel will still come out buccally, you can't have it more palatal because it's the largest angulation that you have. If the multi-unit is too high, you can always change the height of the multi-unit, even though you took an impression on the multi-unit level. For example, if you chose to use here 30 degrees 2 millimeters, you can switch it to 31 or 33, but you can't switch it to 17 or to straight ones. You can make the process so much simpler. You don't have to use implant level scan abutments. In this case, the doctor saw that the angulation with the handle, and because he saw the angulation, he knows what type of multi-unit and what angulation to use. And you see the result is great. All the screw channels go out to the occlusion area. In the lower implants, it could show here that it may be a different angulation, but it doesn't really matter because you can't see it. Later on, it's a temporary bridge. You will have to take impressions again so you can change this multi-unit impression with an angulated multi-unit. Thank you guys for joining in to learn some new and interesting information. Make sure to stay tuned for more. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. See you next time.